All rise, come to order. Hearing court of Dawson County is now in session. Honorable Fred Fisher presiding.
Please be seated. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen.
Good morning.
My name is Fred Bishop. I'm a senior Superior Court judge from Gwinnett County assisting today. And we have on today a special set, civil action number 2017 CV343B, styled as Jeff Johnson as sheriff versus Billy Thurmond as chairman of the County Board of Commissioners, et al. Is the petitioner ready to proceed this morning?
Yes.
And the respondent?
We are, sir.
All right. From an organizational point of view, let me get the names of everybody. Lead counsel for the petitioner will be
Joey Homans.
Okay. And you'll be sitting there, second chair, Mr. Fox, is that right?
Yes.
Yes, sir, that's correct, Judge.
And for the respondent?
Lynn Frey.
Okay. All right, petitioner ready to proceed?
We are, Judge. We would invoke the rule before we give up.
All right, we'll come to that in a moment. And is the respondent ready?
Yes, we are, Judge.
How long do you think, Mr. Homan, how long do you anticipate it's going to take to put your case up?
I would estimate, Judge, a day and a half.
Okay. And the respondent?
Your Honor, in light of what he is anticipating and avoiding duplication, I would say a half day, depending on how much time he involves in cross-examination.
Normally 2 days, well, that's a lawyer talk for 3 days, probably. But anyway.
May well be.
All right. And both sides want this reported?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir, please.
As far as the takedown reporter, you want everything taken down, I guess?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Including opening, closing, and all that.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Right. We'll omit nothing. All right, petitioner had moved to invoke the rule. The rule's invoked as to the defendant's witnesses, or respondent's witnesses.
And we would do the same, Your Honor.
All right. The rule's invoked as to the petitioner's witnesses. Do we have any witnesses? You don't have to step outside. If you have any sides and parties, And I'll ask the attorneys to help keep an eye on your prospective witnesses if anybody comes in and hurt me with.
Yes.
Your Honor, I take it that Ms. Evans will not be called as a witness.
That's correct.
No problem for standing here.
Okay. We have any preliminary motions or issues to address before we commence the argument, Evans?
Judge, the only matter was that we've already addressed in the chambers. Just reserve on the county's list of exhibits the opportunity to review those through this evening since we just received those at 2:30 yesterday.
That'd be fine. And insofar as the petitioner's exhibits, maybe the agreement was, I guess, absent any specific objection, to stipulate those into evidence?
Yes, sir.
Is you have those you want to tender at this point, Mr. Homans?
I do.
We don't have any depositions, that kind of thing at this point?
No, Your Honor.
Okay.
Approach, Judge.
Yes.
I'm going to try to give you an explanation. We tried to mark these in the order, I believe it's 1 through 16.
Okay.
You will have in the packet that I'm handing you, Judge, is a copy of the budget book. I'm going to go ahead and give you the budget book separately, but I'm telling you there's also a copy in the packet.
Okay.
Sub that out later if necessary, and I'll put an appropriate exhibit sticker on the budget book.
Okay. And the originals you have, you're going to use the presentation case and provide that to the court reporter?
Yes. Well, for our court reporter, we're going to make it as difficult as we can. We're going to put them out of order and make him try to keep up. But yes, sir, we're going to put those in so he'll have
okay. Them. All right. That's fine. Mr. Frey, are you able to handle that?
No, sir. No objections to these. And from my understanding of our discussion in chambers, we will be tendering ours at the commencement of our case tomorrow.
Yes. All right. So at this point, the petitioner is a tendering, by way of stipulation, exhibits P1 through P16. Is that
yes,
correct?
Sir. Yes, sir.
All right, any objection to those coming in from the respondent?
No, Your Honor, we don't.
All right, P1 through 16 are admitted. Any other matter we need to address before we commence the opening?
I don't believe so.
Not as to respondents.
All right. All right, the floor is yours, Mr. Homans.
Thank you.
Your Honor, the unfortunate position that we find ourselves in here for this trial is that the Board of Commissioners, based upon the allegations that we believe will be proven from the evidence presented, failed to honor its duty to adopt a budget for Sheriff Johnson that is reasonable and adequate to provide for the personnel and equipment to allow him to perform his duties as sheriff, which requires him to enforce the law and preserve the peace under the Constitution and statutes of Georgia. We submit that the Board of Commissioners, the evidence is going to show, failed to honor this obligation imposed by law, primarily, Judge, because they relied upon incorrect information in adopting this 2018 budget. And what the evidence is going to show that what the, this is in, it'll be in one of our exhibits, Judge, but as we go through, let me try to turn this so maybe there we go. Judge, what this is going to become a focus, and if I can pull it out a little bit, I went the wrong way. What it's going to show is that this was presented by our commission chairman, Mr. Thurmond,
And under the law, Judge, it's a little bit unusual in Dawson County. Evidence is going to show under our enacting legislation. The chairman presents the budget as opposed to the county manager or the chief financial officer of the county. So the chairman has the duty and obligation to present the budget to be considered by the Board of Commissioners for approval. And Mr. Thurmond set about to do that, and the evidence will show that on August the 10th of 2017, when he was presenting for the Board of Commissioners for the 2018 budget, which is the issue that brings us here, that the chairman showed $7,334,486 is what he was proposing for 18. This is the number that will become significant, Judge. What was relied upon by the Board of Commissioners in showing what fiscal year 2017 was, is $6,822,566. The reason that will be significant, Your Honor, is that the evidence here will show that in 2017, the Board of Commissioners approved a budget that set aside at that time $350,000 for salary increases for 17. Now, I'm not talking about 18, for 17. But it wasn't categorized. It wasn't set aside for a specific department or a specific office. The evidence will also show that the Board of Commissioners came back in April of 2017 and they amended that 17 budget. And they added $374,440.42 for salary increases, rendering that a grand total of $724,440.42. At that time, Judge, of necessity, the evidence will show that increased this 17 budget by department. And when you add that increase, because the evidence will be the Sheriff's Department has roughly 50% of the employees impacted by that salary increase, based upon numbers that the county puts out in various reports, which would render the increase to the Sheriff's Department budget in fiscal year 2017 would increase this number by approximately $362,000. So the Board of Commissioners went forward to adopt a budget believing that the change in the budget was 7.5%. The evidence will be that that increase was substantially lower, in somewhere between 2% and 2.5%, and that the budget amendments were in April of 2017, and the budget was put together throughout May, June, and July, and then the chairman presented this. So there was sufficient time to calculate that budget amendment and make sure they were relying upon correct information when adopting this budget, because the sheriff's critical need will be people. He needs staff. He's insufficiently staffed. Furthermore, unfortunately for the Board of Commissioners in trying to render their decision and exercise their discretion, they filed a verified answer for us, Judge. And what that answer shows, I just want you to see this number of $9,173,80. In their answer, county says total approved budget for FY18 was $9,173,80. Judge, and I also want to explain that we expect the evidence throughout this trial to show that the way a budget is put together here in Dawson County can create some confusion, because what the chairman had put in and what we discussed during the budget hearings, the chairman did not include SPLOST money, capital project money, or E911. He addressed those separately outside the sheriff's budget. In other county budget documents, the evidence will be that those items were included. So you're going to see a wild variation in numbers, but I believe that will be explained during the hearing and the trial, that it depends upon whether you include E911 or whether you include capital project items in the sheriff's budget. But you'll see, I'm emphasizing this number 9173080, because our belief is the evidence is going to show that this is another document that's part of the exhibits, that where the county erred, let's see if I can get to this, Judge. This, I'm going to scroll back up, Judge, but this $600,000, the evidence is going to show that that's SPLOST 6 money. And unfortunately for the Board of Commissioners, this is the county's approved budget document. When we do the math, when we put up the witnesses, the evidence is going to show that included in that $9,173,080 is that SPLOST money of $600,000. And the county's verified answer says that the sheriff has discretion to move that money around. That's what they believe. But that's not the law. And we'll argue the law at the appropriate time, but they just relied upon incorrect information. As I've told you, Judge, the evidence here is going to be the sheriff's critical need is people. You now have as an exhibit what the sheriff says he needs. And I have to get better with this machine or come back to it, but that's the overall exhibit I want you to see. You will have, and it's in your budget book, and Mr. Harlsworth will be here to testify from the Georgia Sheriff's Association, that in year 2015, according to Mr. Harlsworth's study, the Dawson County Board of Commissioners should have funded 139 positions for the Dawson County Sheriff's Office. The evidence will be that the Sheriff's Office is the only law enforcement agency in this county. That's a little bit unusual for our area. Most other counties have either a city law enforcement agency or multiple city law enforcement agencies and or university police or another law enforcement agency to assist in preserving the peace and enforcing the law. For 2018, I'll have to turn it, Judge, and I know that's hard to read, but I want you to see what I'm doing there. What the sheriff came in and said was these positions were frozen years and years ago, and he's asking that these positions be unfrozen and that one position be added. So he's saying I have 112 positions now, and I want to go to 122, and that's the bare minimum, because to get to 15, I would need 139. Evidence will be Dawson County has exploded with growth since 2015. All you have to do is drive up 400 and look at the Kroger Center and the Public Center that have opened since then, and the sheriff will offer testimony about the growth in population and permits, and we'll have testimony about the increased number of calls, but it's just common sense. But I go back to this because the evidence will be that the county manager of Dawson County has seen fit to issue press releases and establish a public relations campaign with one of the local press groups, and has asserted on more than one occasion that the sheriff of Dawson County complains that we don't have enough patrol, but we didn't even ask for patrol. Now, he told that to the press, but he won't talk with the sheriff, and they won't talk with me, because the evidence will be that out of these positions, it will be patrol. The evidence will be, and had anybody asked, the sheriff would have told them, accreditation manager was the name of the position when it was frozen. That is a patrol position. The canine sergeant is on time, will be added to patrol for Dawson County. The SRO that the commissioners approved with the assistance of the Board of Education, and they also removed money they had previously allocated for a SWAT team or for equipment for SWAT team to fund it. But that position provides patrol. So the Board of Commissioners, based upon those press releases, believe what was stated, that he's not adding any patrol, but the evidence will be that if these positions are awarded, he will have patrol. And the evidence will be that what the sheriff was trying to do was get to this 2015 staffing analysis so that he could have sufficient positions to enforce the law and preserve the peace here in Dawson County. And so to slice those positions and just award one a school resource officer prevents him from doing his duty. The division commander is going to testify, Judge. The sheriff is going to testify. Mr. Hallsworth is going to testify about the impact of not having these divisions and these staff, the divisions fully staffed the way that they should be. And it frankly, Judge, will, we submit, indicate the dangerous situation that's placed for these officers and for the public. I'll let the division commanders go in, and frankly, Judge, we're going to ask them questions that just let them testify. But the examples will be that in the investigations division, the investigators, they don't assign to a specific type of crime because they don't have sufficient personnel to do that. The evidence will be that we don't even have an evidence custodian officer assigned full-time to do that job. Instead, one of our detectives has to spend about 30% of his time doing the evidence custodian work as well as all the other work he needs to do. And as a result of that, for example, on the drug surveillance, the commander of the investigators is going to testify that they're unable to do proper surveillance. They just don't have the necessary personnel. The evidence is going to be that when there's a major crime, because they're not specifically assigned, they've got to pull everybody off of whatever other investigations they're doing to investigate a child molestation or some other major crime. And oddly, Judge, the evidence is going to be that as a result of the budget assigned by the commissioner, they don't even have any administrative assistants over there. So as a result of that, each detective is having to prepare their own report. They're responsible for providing that over to the district attorney's office and doing all the other items that they should be able to assign to an administrative assistant. And that prevents them from enforcing the law and preserving the peace. It prevents them from getting the bad guys off the street in the investigations division. In the patrol division, the evidence is going to be that they really don't patrol, Judge. All they do, I believe his phrase is going to be, we're call takers. And so that means that they get a call, that they run to another call. As soon as it's finished, they've got to go to another. And they're unable to perform that patrol division, and that leads to a higher traffic fatality rate and other serious injuries. In the court services division, they oversee warrants. The highlight, Judge, I submit there as a result of not having a sufficient number of officers is there are hundreds of criminal warrants waiting to be served because those officers have to provide the court security and the other duties, and they generally have to send two officers out, and so it's a matter of getting the time where they can send the two officers out to serve warrants. In the detention center, the evidence will be we don't meet standards. Again, and by standards, I mean the Sheriff's Association provides standards, there's national standards, and that we're unable to meet those. Again, the Board of Commissioners relied upon incorrect information because we submit the evidence is going to show that they believe, that is, the Board of Commissioners believe, if your inmate population goes down, therefore you ought to have fewer people needed in your detention center. You'll hear from the sheriff, you'll hear from Mr. Hallsworth, you'll hear from our detention center commander or the assistant that will tell you that's not the case. That in order to properly run a detention center, you've got to have a minimum number of personnel serving that role. Our E911 director will be here to testify as to any statistics that may be challenged, but in general, the evidence is going to be those call volumes are going up. There's one item, Judge, in here that we submit further shows that the commissioners have abused their discretion. On the budget, sorry, I had it with me, Judge. On the budget, the evidence is going to be this $260,000 that's labeled here on this budget summary exhibit has been placed into a capital project fund. And you may know this, Judge, but I need to make sure it's in the record. A computer-aided dispatch system is what the
sheriff put in his budget book under capital projects. That's one of the items he put. And in the budget book, it's going to show that the cost currently, or at least when he presented it, was over $500,000 to get an entirely new computer-aided dispatch system.
And what that does is it allows the call, well, you know this, but it allows the calls to come in, and then the radio can dispatch out to the emergency, including the sheriff, but EMS, ambulances, so that they can understand and be safe when they're going about their business. But this item was placed into this capital project fund with restrictions. This 260 was placed in here with restrictions, and it's beyond the sheriff's discretion. In other words, the sheriff can't move that around the way it was approved in the budget, that it's just set aside. And as opposed to considering any sort of lease purchase option, any considering using SPLOST funds for this 260 to free this up so that he can provide staffing, which is his critical need for manpower, the Board of Commissioners set this item here, saying, okay, well, next year we'll add to it. Well, we don't know what the cost will be next year. And also to place that, to isolate that to within the sheriff's budget when it improves the performance of all emergency, we submit shows an abuse of discretion. The sheriff will also testify that as a result, and all of his division commanders, because of the limited staff that they have, they're having to work more overtime, and that they're unable to have meetings, pre-shift meetings. I call it the old NYPD meetings, where the NYPD TV show used to begin, where they were having the staff meetings. They can't do that at Dawson County Sheriff's Office. People are working overtime, and also because when they come in, they don't have sufficient budget to work that in for that little 30-minute review. But that's critical, Judge, and they'll tell you why it's all critical. We submit that at the end of the presentation, we will have established that the Board of Commissioners have abused their discretion. We don't submit that they've abused their discretion necessarily, although it may be that there's some personality issue or there's some other issue. But the evidence will be that the information was there, but they just relied on different and incorrect information in setting this budget. And for those reasons, we're going to request that you issue a writ that allows the sheriff's office to properly perform their duties and requires the Board of Commissioners to provide a budget for him to do that. Thank you.
Your Honor, I've reserved my opening until the commencement of our portion case tomorrow or later today, whatever that may be.
That'll be fine. Let me ask, so I make sure I understand what it is you want. What I'd like is, what are you asking me to do? You want me to sign an order that says what for the petitioner?
Judge, I think all that the law permits you to do is to issue a writ requiring the Board of Commissioners to issue and provide a budget to Sheriff Johnson that's sufficient to allow him to perform his duties. And we submit that the budget they've issued does not do that.
But it would be not numbers, but what you're saying is just simply, we want a new budget that includes the furnishing part of all these items.
Yes, sir. I think that's all the law permits you to do. I don't think the law allows you to say you've got to award X amount.
I think you're right. Mr. Fry, what do you say? What do you want?
I believe he is correct about that. The law does not contemplate putting the burden on the Superior Court judge of becoming a budget officer and forming the budget, whether it's one he requests or otherwise. I think the way he just characterized it is if you should find in favor of the request for mandamus, it would be something along those lines.
Okay. All right. Call you first, please.
We call Sheriff Johnson, please.
You can take whatever you need.
Judge, I will tell you that not only Sheriff Johnson, but I expect other witnesses, because we're talking about numbers. I want Ms. Frey to know that he's got some papers with him, because we've done some calculations on try to do them here, but Sheriff Johnson and other witnesses may have some documents with them regarding that kind of information.
That's fine. Mr. Frey can examine on cross fields.
Exactly, and I may exercise my right to review whatever sure. It is they're using to refresh their memories.
That'd be fine.
We've included those based upon their records as well as the records that are in. Raise your right hand and solemnly swear or affirm the testimony you're about to give should be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, so help you God.
I do.
Have a seat, please, sir.
Give me just a second.
You're Sheriff Jeff Johnson, is that correct?
Yes, sir.
Tell the judge your background, experience, and education, please.
Your Honor, I've 25 years of law enforcement this March. Began my career in Hall County in the early 90s, working in the detention center, the house arrest, work release area, transferred to the city of Gainesville, served about 10 years there, about 8 years there, in a patrol capacity and a supervisor capacity and in criminal investigations. Come over here in Dawson County, although I've lived here for 34 years this year, I come over here in Dawson County in 2004. I was an investigator here. I've served probably around 7 years under Sheriff Carlisle, the previous sheriff, as jail administrator, as a major. Have approximately 3,000 hours of training, extensive experience in detention, criminal investigations, patrol, in courts. At one time I was the court commander as well. Was blessed to be elected sheriff in 2016, and I took office January 1, 2017.
And you may have mentioned this, Sheriff, and I may have just missed it, your educational background.
Yes, graduated from Dawson County High School as well as the University of North Georgia. It was the Gainesville Junior College at the time, but while I was there, they were changed to the University of North Georgia.
And the courses you mentioned in your training, who offered those courses? What field was that?
Well, they were various. At one time I was an instructor, so a lot of instructor type training, supervision type training, which dealt with budgets, things of that nature, offered through the Georgia Public Safety Training Center as well as through various other offsite locations.
All right. Now, in connection with any other law enforcement agency, did you ever participate in the budget process other than Dawson County?
Well, there's always input from command staff and from supervisory staff, things of that nature. It gains extensively.
Now, you were elected in 2016, is that correct?
That's correct.
Started January 1, 2017.
Yes, sir.
And as a result, did you participate at all in the Sheriff's Office budget process for calendar year 2017? So in other words, in 2016, before you took office, did you participate Sheriff's Office budgeting process through the county for 17?
I did. It was minimal. That year was election year as well as the Sheriff's Select Academy and things of that nature, but I was able during the periods to work with Ms. Evans on the budget.
All right. These are in the exhibits that we have that have been admitted by stipulation. What I'm going to try to do, Sheriff, to make this flow, put these on the screen rather than handing you a pile of paper.
Yes.
Okay? Exhibit 3 This was when the Board of Board of Commissioners. I'm going to start backwards and work my way in. But this is from November 10, 2016. You see that?
Yes, sir, I do.
Right. And then these were the approvals subject
In other words, approved what the chairman at that time presented, subject to these amendments, correct?
Which number is this?
It's number three, Judge. I'm going to do 3, 4, and 5 with Sheriff Johnson, go over these with him. Now, Sheriff, if we look through these, now again, this, I'm going to go back to the documents that were presented as part of that budget, but as far as these amendments that were made, so that the judge will understand, the ones that impacted the sheriff's office here was just the bottom. You increased the amount for the chief deputy. Was that you or was that anybody else?
Was that another department?
No, sir, that is the sheriff's office.
That's the sheriff's department. So other than that, were any of these other amendments different than what the chairman had presented?
Not that I see, no, sir.
Now, Exhibit 4. Is a multi-page exhibit that consists of the chairman's presentation. Hang on just a second. Tried to pre-mark the areas we need to go to, but it's a multi-page exhibit, so if you give me just a second. All right, this was the budget presentation that the chairman at that time presented, correct?
Yes, sir.
That was for 17, and it was initially presented 2006 on September 15, right?
Yes, sir.
Now, within this budget presentation, the chairman provided for positions for the sheriff's office. Is that right?
That's correct.
All right. This what was provided for the chief deputy and the corporal investigator, correct?
That's correct.
All right, now the E-91 supervisor, was that falls under your discretion and control?
Yes, sir, it does.
All right. Explain to the judge, at times, is this amount or is this E-911 separated in county budgets?
Yes, sir, it is.
All right, and is that done in connection with you or is that just the way it's done?
I don't know the reason, Mr. Holmes.
All right. And at other times on county budget documents that you've reviewed, the E-91 is included within your budget?
Correct.
All right. Now, within this 17 budget presentation, see that middle where it says salary adjustment history and then the next dot that says additional $350,000. You see that part?
Yes, sir.
All right. And as best you understand, based upon the county records, that was approved. Is that correct, Sheriff?
Correct.
All right. Was that $350,000 at that time put into the sheriff's budget for 2017?
No, sir.
Then, the county came back and amended the budget in April of 2017. Is that accurate?
That is correct.
Look, before I get to April. Exhibit 5, which again is a multi-page exhibit, which is the final approved 2017 budget. Show you, Judge, this will start over on, it's listed as page 1 of expenditures. But you, and you probably can't read that because it's not coming too clear. Let me leave it alone for just a second. Okay. So you get over here to where, let's also explain this to the judge. You see at the top where it says 2017, 2017, one's requested and one is recommended.
What exhibit number is this?
This is 5.
Okay. Yes, sir, I see it.
All right, and for ease of clarification for Judge Bishop, does recommended mean the budget amount?
That's what's recommended to the board.
All right, and if the board approves this budget, then that's the amount within the budget.
That's correct.
And what does requested mean?
That's what we feel through our budget process is requested.
That's what you asked for, right? Now, did you go through on the sheriff's side of this, because it's broken out here, you've got sheriff's services, you've got school resource officers. In other words, it's not all directly in a row. Is that correct?
That's correct.
All right. But did you go through and add up this amount that was approved back in November of 2016?
Yes, we did.
All right. And did that number come out to be the amount that Chairman Thurmond presented in 2017 as the sheriff's budget for 17, the $6,800,000 I just presented in opening?
Based upon what was originally budgeted for 17, that would have been correct after the amended budget. That's incorrect.
Right. That's all I'm asking is the comparison numbers that Mr. Thurmond used when he presented his budget included what was approved in November of 2016 for the 17 budget, right?
Correct.
Did it take into account the amended budget from April?
I'm sorry, run that.
Did the comparison numbers that were presented, hang on just a second. Comparison numbers that Mr. Thurmond presented when he presented the 18 proposed budget, did this $6,822,566, is that the amount that the Board of Commissioners approved in November of 16 for the 17 budget?
Yes.
All right. Now, you had started, and I got off kilter here, there were amendments to that budget. In April of 17, is that right?
Correct.
Right. And there, this is what was approved on April the 6th, and Judge, this is exhibit number 6, where it says motion passed unanimously to approve the FY 2017 budget amendment for salary study pre-implementation. Is that right?
Correct.
And Sheriff Are you familiar, do you have information there that can help you to answer about how many positions you have within the sheriff's office in 2017 at the time of this budget amendment?
112.
And Sheriff, do you understand that was half or roughly half of all of the employees affected by this budget amendment?
Estimated.
Now, as to that budget amendment, it references a salary study. And this is, Your Honor, Exhibit 7. I've got to back it up so you can see. You familiar with this form, Sheriff?
Yes, sir.
And this is the kind of information that's presented to the Board of Commissioners when an item is for their, before them for consideration.
That is correct.
Now, as a focus in here, the salary cost of option 2 full year, tell Judge Bishop what that means, what that indicated. The first line there, salary cost of option 2. Were there many options being considered by the board?
I don't recall, Mr. Holmes. Okay.
And did the board approve an across-the-board increase?
Yes, sir. Not even across the board, but there were raises.
All right. And the total amount that was added to the total, well, let's just go through it. The total amount that this salary increase would increase the county budget was $724,440.42, according to this exhibit, right?
Yes, sir.
And this amount budgeted, that $350,000, that was back from the November budget, right?
Correct.
Again, that was not assigned to specific departments or offices. That was just an amount set aside, right?
Correct.
So, the total increase to the budget as a result of this amendment was this $374,440.42, right?
Correct.
All right. Now, when those salaries are implemented as they were here, did that then increase the budget to the sheriff's office for 17?
Yes, it did.
All right. So, Sheriff, you say you have approximately 50% of the employees impacted by this amount. In other words, it's hard to get an exact number, but approximately 50%. So if there's, and none of the 350 was previously assigned to your budget, right?
Correct.
All right. So if we use the full 724,440.42, we divide that by 2, is that how much it increased your budget approximately?
Yes, approximately.
362. And so then when you went into your budget for 18, that was necessarily already included.
That's correct.
All right. And just to complete the thought on Exhibit 8, this was the formal resolution that the Board of Commissioners approved increasing that budget as of April 6, 2017, right?
Yes, sir.
Salary study references, or excuse me, the budget increase references a salary study.
Right.
You're familiar with that salary study?
I am.
Let me ask, make sure I understand. Is your contention that in the 2017 budget there was the numbers you were just talking about, $600,000-$700,000, that was monies approved, funded, and spent in 2017, about half of which went to the sheriff's in the sheriff's budget. That was the salaries, that sort of thing.
Yes, sir.
And then it was not included in the 2018 budget. Is that what you're saying?
it would have necessarily been included in the 18 budget because they gave the salary increase, but when the Board of Commissioners were considering the 18 budget, they did not include the amended amount for 17. So the Board of Commissioners believed they were giving a greater increase to the sheriff's office in 18 than what they actually gave.
Okay. But it's still there, it just wasn't funded for 2018.
Well,
I mean, in essence, I guess.
Well, it was funded, Judge, but our point is the Board of Commissioners did not realize, or didn't, at least in their paperwork they did with their budget, they didn't include the.
They didn't carry over the increase to 2018 to take care of it. Okay, all right. Go ahead, please.
Now, is this the salary study that was relied upon to increase the budget for 17?
Looks like it, yes, sir.
And it's a multi-page.
What exhibit number is that?
This is number 9. It's a multi-page exhibit that contains a variety of options, and the Board of Commissioners picked number 2, correct?
Correct.
Now, let me also ask you that in the methodology for this salary study, upon which the commissioners relied in rendering their decision, they relied upon 10 peer organizations, right? At the bottom?
Correct.
All right. And that includes Cherokee, Forsyth, Gwinnett, and Hall, right?
Correct.
As well as Cumming and Gainesville. Now, have you encountered an issue as sheriff or in your years at the sheriff's office with officers transferring from Dawson County to other departments?
Absolutely.
All right. And are any of those departments listed here as peer organizations?
Yes, sir. Forsyth, Hall, occasionally Lumpkin, and Gainesville.
So you do have, I'm sorry.
And Cherokee.
All right. And you do have, so then you do have comparisons with counties that are larger than Dawson County that are in our area.
Yes, sir.
All right. And one of the, I just want to clean, make sure we've gone through this, the recommendations on this pay plan, options to consider the across the board increase, is that what was done, or whether there wasn't another option that was selected?
If my memory serves me correct, I believe it was the cost of the minimum. I'm not sure, not sure exactly which it was entitled.
All right. Now, as well, on this is Exhibit 10, there was a further amendment to the budget to fund additional positions, correct?
Correct.
Right. And again, Judge, this is April 10 minutes. It's Exhibit number, or April 20 minutes, it's Exhibit number 10. And in this budget amendment, there was an approval for a planning and development budget amendment to add an assistant, correct?
Correct.
And there was also an amendment to approve planning and development budget amendment for a building inspector, right?
Correct.
You had no positions added in the sheriff's office other than the 3 you've already mentioned, correct? In 17.
17, that's correct.
All right. But then, when Mr. Thurmond presented his budget, that we previously referenced, that is part of Exhibit 11, I'm sorry, I keep going wrong. Proposed budget highlights for 18, now this is 2018, again, what Chairman Thurmond presented. There it says no new positions, right?
Correct.
All right. So in that situation, the amendment from 2017 was taken into account, right? The amendment from April of 2017 was taken into account to make this statement true, that there were no new positions.
Yes, sir.
But the amendment on the total for the sheriff's office, or excuse me, the presentation for the total of the sheriff's office did not take into account the amendment from April 6th.
Correct.
All right. All right. Get to the 2018 budget. I'm going to start going in the order that we've been going with exhibits 14 and 15. Exhibit 14 is the meeting September the 21 of 2017, and that was when the 2018 budget was approved with changes. Here are the changes. I want you to, for right now, I want you to look here on the change that is made, and you'll see if you'll come all the way down to Sheriff 3300 SWAT, small equipment. You see that?
Yes, sir.
What amount was previously there, Sheriff?
$15,000.
That was removed to fund the SRO and that school resource officer, is that right?
That's correct.
Right. And then we get over here to the capital projects fund. You see the $260,000 for the 911 CAD and the $40,000 for HVAC.
I do, yes, sir.
Right. Now, explain to the judge what is meant there by CAD. I know it's just second nature to you, but if you'll just explain that to the judge, please.
Well, our CAD is our computer-aided dispatch. And basically where we're at right now, we have a rather antiquated system. We have frequently issues with it. Breakdowns, we're unable to accept text messages, we're unable to accept photographs, things of that nature. The $260,000 was set aside for future use for CAD system.
And have you included as a project need in your budget book that's also in evidence as our Exhibit 12, have you included reference to that CAD system?
Yes, sir, that is correct.
Sheriff, and it's in there, but do you recall the bid or whatever you received as to what the cost for that would be if it was timely purchased from when you got the bid?
I believe that one was about $550,000.
And, well, the HVAC is also shown in the capital project fund, right?
Correct.
Well, what's that? Tell the judge what that's for.
That's basically our heat and air, Judge. We're, our facility's going on 11, 12 years old. These things run 24 hours a day, and we're beginning to replace them in segments. We were able to replace three major ones last year, and we hope to be able to do the same this year.
All right. Now, as a result of that approved budget, and for whatever reason, Sheriff, these just come out smaller, and I apologize. That's just the way we received them. So I'm going to take a broader view and I'll hone in as we go. But if we come down here to sheriff, this is your part of the budget, right?
Correct.
All right. This is what was approved as it's shown here. 2018 approved budget, okay? We've got a series of columns that we've got to work through up here at the top. For our purposes of discussion, you've got general fund, E911 fund. Now, if we come over here, we've also got SPLOST 6 and capital projects, okay? Sheriff, I've got my calculator and I'm happy to hit whatever button, but I know you've worked on this since November. The county says in their answer that the total amount provided to you, including E911, is $9,564,324. You've seen that in their verified answer, correct?
Yes.
So if we go to the totals column that applies to you, so we have to come down here to where before we get to Marshall's, I can't make it all show and I apologize, Sheriff, but what I'm telling you is, as I come down these columns, I'm gonna stop here at Sheriff's Court Services, and then I'm gonna come down here to E911, okay?
May I interrupt and ask, what exhibit number you're looking at?
Thought I told you.
You did.
Exhibit 15.
Okay. Thank you.
Good?
Thank you.
All right, you back with me, Sheriff?
Yes, sir.
All right. So then we start over here with general fund. Come over here to totals, okay? And if you run the math of the items down to Sheriff's Court Services and the E911, have you added those up?
Yes, sir, at some point.
You want to do it again?
I probably have the paperwork over there, Mr. Holman.
Right. You believe that that total is $9,564,324?
Yes, sir, sounds correct.
Can you see it on your screen?
Well, it's down right now, but I can't see it. Yes, sir.
All right. I'm gonna bring you the calculator.
And Mr. Holmes, would you pull it over to where I can see the 911? Okay, there it is. $9,564,324.
Okay. And that's what the county said in their answer, is the total for the budget. However, the county also, in their verified answer, said that the budget subject to your discretion is $9,173,080. So that difference is $391,244. Sheriff, the $260,000, as you told the judge, that's in that capital project fund, that was restricted, right?
That's correct.
Tell the judge what we mean by restricted.
It's not allowed to be used for staffing, things of that nature. It's set aside, my understanding, just for future purchase of a CAD system.
And you don't even have control over that money, do you?
No, sir, I don't.
All right. And you also don't have control over the grant funds of 112204.
That's
right?
Correct.
Or these grant funds of 4040.
That's correct.
And they had removed 15,000 from the SWAT fund, as you previously testified and as shown by the exhibit, right?
That's correct.
And while you've got the calculator there, will you add 260? 112,204. 4,040. And 15,000.
If I've done it correctly, 131,504.
Let's go, let's get all the numbers in there. If you'll zero it out. 260,000 plus 112,204, 4,040, and 15,000.
Okay. 391,244.
Okay. So then, with that difference, the $9,173,080 that the county contends is subject to your discretion still includes that splashed money right here of $600,000, doesn't it?
Correct.
You don't have discretion over splashed money, do you, Sheriff?
Not for staffing, no, sir.
Tell the judge, when you presented your proposed budget for 2018 to the Board of Commissioners, that's contained in this notebook that I've given the judge, when did you present it?
I would have to look at the date on that initial letter, Mr. Holman, so that would be an approximate.
Go ahead, whatever the approximate.
I don't have it with me.
The budget book?
Yes, sir.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Let me ask Mr. Holmes, you're going to be a while longer with this witness, I presume?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, well, we've been going for a while. Maybe it's a good time. Just, we'll take a 15-minute recess, and then we'll recommit some push on. We'll take 15 minutes at this point.
Thank you, Judge.
Are you better?